So, Sal, let's talk about this quarterback carousal, if you will.
Yeah, damn, N-word. What the hell is carousal?
I don't know how to pronounce no words. You're telling me I got to get rid of words. No. I got to use words. Man, I don't even know.
Yeah, get rid of carousal. Put it in carousel.
I ain't talking to you.
Anyway, is the door open for the Cowboys to make a run in the NFC?
Yes, it is. And here's the most awkward transition in sports talk history. You go from the N-word to talking about the Dallas Cowboys. But, yeah, I really think they could make a run, big dog. Let me tell you why. All they have to do is win their 7-win division, and they're in. And once you're in, what did Kevin Garnett say? Anything is possible! And Adidas is sitting there like, damn, the hell on the biggest stage? He messed up our damn slogan. The slogan is impossible is nothing. I get why Garnett changed it. That's a better slogan than what he said. But the point is, anything is possible. Oh, you don't think so? Remember last year, somebody was whispering to you. Then I started to yell, Tampa Bay Buccaneers, 7 wins. Watch him turn it around. Tom Brady's in the building. Different quarterback. Everything changes. Why? Because the quarterback is the most important position. And if you look at the Dallas Cowboys, they got a different quarterback. Oh, they got Dak Prescott coming back off injury, paid with security, with equity. And now they realize, finally, we appreciate Dak because we are different without Dak. So all he has to do is go out there, win the games in that division that he is 19-6 in terms of his record in the NFC East. And then 3 of those losses came in his rookie year, so he's really like 16-3. Woo-hoo-hoo. Dak owns the NFC least, right? So now he gets in. And what happened with those Tampa Bay Bucks? That can happen with these Dallas Cowboys. Just go start slaying dragons. Washington football team, your defense. Yeah, I got to get out of here. Drew Brees, you want to retire? Bow, get up out of here. Aaron Rodgers, they want to trade you or at least demote you. Bow, get up out of here. Patrick Mahomes, no one doubts you. Bow, now they do. And that can happen with a team that was 7-9 the year before, quarterback change, and a lot of other parts of talent. Now, here's the part that you got to mix up. Here's the gumbo. Dallas Cowboys got talent. A lot of talent. Because if the Dallas Cowboys were to make a run, go deep in the playoffs, you know what most people would say? About damn time. You know why you would say that? Because you had an expectation based on this same talent. And then if you look at them and they possess the talent and they actually make it come to fruition, you're going to say, wow, it finally happened. So all those things are bubbling right underneath the surface. Acho, look deeper than the top layer and see these Cowboys poised for a run.
Strong take,
James Worthy style right here.
Strong take. But no, the Cowboys aren't poised to make a run in the NFC. So if you want to get out of my complex, my building's complex, you got to get out of several doors.
Right.
First off, if you're in the bedroom, you got to get out the bedroom door. You got to get out the front
door. First of all, why am I in your bedroom?
Not you.
I'm the only one here.
I am in my bedroom. Got to get out the bedroom door.
Okay.
Got to get out the front door. Then you got to get out the door that lets you out to the street. Cowboys might, maybe, get out the bedroom door which is the NFC East, right? Okay. That's the door closest to them. They might, maybe, get out that door, but somebody got to explain to me.
Shut up.
Cowboys finished third last year in the NFC East.
Not the Cowboys. That wasn't Dak.
No, the Cowboys finished third last year in the NFC East.
Here you go.
And I would say that, yes, the Cowboys got better, but the Giants also got better, and they probably got better at a greater rate than the Cowboys did. Washington, who also finished better than the Dallas Cowboys, they got better at a greater rate than the Cowboys did. Mm. Are the Cowboys returning Dak Prescott? Absolutely. But remember, before Dak Prescott went down, the Cowboys were only 1-3. You can argue that they were 2-3 because Dak's backup finished that game. But Sal, for the Cowboys fans watching this show, and I know y'all are dedicated historians, football fans that are historians, remember, 2015, the Cowboys finished 4-12. At the end of that season, if you were to ask me, can the Cowboys make a run in the NFC East? I'd say, yes, they can. Because the Cowboys finished 4-12 because their starting quarterback, Tony Romo, got hurt, only played 4 games. Mm. In the 4 games Tony Romo played, they were 3-1. They finished 4-12. And the 4 games Dak Prescott played, they were 1-3. So the Cowboys were still bad with Dak Prescott. So why would I think
slow, you mean,
that they can be better next year, even though they were bad with Dak Prescott? Ask me that question at the end of 2015. Hey, next year, are the Cowboys going to be favorites in the NFC? Yeah, because if their starter comes back, they're a much better team.
Mm.
Even with Dak Prescott, the Cowboys still were not a very good team. So, no, they cannot make a run, because even with Dak Prescott, they were not making a run, sir.
Man, stop.
That, what?
I love you in this projection that you love to make on all these players and all these teams. All these teams. Okay, let's do your projection game. Here's a story of the Pittsburgh Steelers that were 11-0. Your projection would say they're going to win it all. How'd that turn out? Dudes won one more game after that, okay, big dog? And then you look at the Dallas Cowboys, what you say, 1-3?
1-3.
How do you know they couldn't do the same flip? Because that's the way the ball bounces. The ball didn't bounce for the Cowboys their way last year. But you know, as someone who had to recover fumbles, that ball bounces all types of ways.
It does.
Every single time. What if the ball bounced the Cowboys' way this year? And think about it. At the end of the season, being real, looking at the defense, you're writing notes. That means I got you. Because you give me a lot, I write a lot of notes. Did the defense have the most takeaways since week 11 last year? Yeah, they did. Were they 11th in scoring defense, which is from the bottom to 11th, means you're starting to turn the corner. Didn't the Tampa Bay Buccaneers defense start to turn the corner second half of the season 2 years ago as well? Yes, they did. Let's talk about how the Cowboys right now. Look at this situation. Dak Prescott gives you 32.5 points per game. You talked about in those four games. That would have led the league in scoring, you know what? So let's project that all the way out. This team offensively will score 32 points a game, average. Huh. And the defense started to turn the corner second half of the season. Huh. And Ezekiel Elliott realizes it's time to go get mine because everyone's saying I'm in decline. Yeah, I know it rhymes, bars. So then all of a sudden you got now Dan Quinn in the building working with a defense that started to turn the corner. Mike McCarthy, we know he's a Super Bowl champion coach. Dak Prescott back healthy. You start mixing up that gumbo, finally take a taste. They win a division. They're in the playoffs.
And you spit it out. Because, Sal, you go broke banking on what ifs. What if the ball bounces the Cowboys' way? It ain't bounced their way in 25 years. Sal, come with me real quick to a place called the Sugar House. The Sugar House is a casino in Philadelphia and South Philly. Come with me to the Sugar House, and here where we going to go. We're not going to go to the blackjack table. We're going to pass that blackjack table. We're going to pass the baccarat tables, and we're going to post up at the roulette table. Because the roulette got one of them little balls, and there are about 38 holes that the ball can bounce in. And you want to know how everybody goes broke at the roulette table?
Why?
By saying what you said. But what if the ball bounces my way this time? What if I spin it and the ball bounces my way? Put 5,000 on 36.
5K, boy!
Because what if it bounces my way? That's how you go broke. Because the ball ain't bounced the Cowboys' way in 25 years. I am not going to blindly hope, blindly wish that the ball might bounce the Cowboys' way when I have no statistical data, no offseason acquisition, no metric to assume that the ball might bounce their way.
Objection, Your Honor. I don't know who this lawyer is in that cheap suit, but he is making up stuff. Sustain. You know what? You know what's wrong with you?
What's up, Sal?
Who won the Super Bowl last year? The
Bucks.
Huh?
Buccaneers.
Say it with your chest.
The Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Buccaneers.
How many times they won the Super Bowl before this?
One time,
2002.
Right?
Yeah. And is that 19 years ago? Oh, okay. So you're saying it can't happen in 25 years, but it happened just now in 19 years. And who was the sorriest franchise in sports history by win-loss percentage?
I've not confirmed
that. Same Tampa Bay Bucks, but now they changed. They're second worst because of the Super Bowl championship. The year before, the ball bounces differently. Who won the Super Bowl?
The greatest quarterback of all time showed up. That was the ball bouncing.
Okay, what about the year before?
The greatest quarterback
ever. Patrick Mahomes, not the greatest quarterback of all time yet. But how did they win it? And they hadn't, when the last time they won a Super Bowl? 50 years! Didn't win a Super Bowl at all. The point of it is the ball can bounce that way. The point of it is at the Sugar House, Acho's face is up on that wall because the ball bounced your way just one time.